For the man that pilgrims alone, said the mother in indignant word. Okay, pilgrim. Pilgrim means a traveler or a wanderer without aim. That means a wanderer who moves without any aim, okay, any purpose, alone for them. Okay, so she's asking, Mother Earth is, sorry, the poet is asking whether can he sing about those seeds and prophets, okay, about them who shaped our life, that means who enriched our knowledge, and they have changed the society by their knowledge. So the poet is asking, shall I sing about those seeds and prophets? Okay, said the mother in indignant word. Indignant means the words filled with anger. Okay, that beat into my ears like a gong, that flew about me a pitiful thing like a great white bird. Okay, so here mother, she becomes very angry, and she said in angry that she's very angry, and these words, that means whatever the poet is telling, no, all those words are okay, like a gong. A gong means a metal disc with a turned rim, that means jagate. Okay, so don't think about, okay, she says that his words are beating like a gong in his ears, and she says let it fly, okay, with like a white birds. Okay, so now here the poet is telling that these words are beating, that means whatever the poet is telling, those words are beating his ears like a gong. So beat into my ears like a gong, that flew about me a pitiful thing like a great white bird. Okay, indignant. Indignant means the words filled with anger. So said the mother in indignant word, that means mother, she becomes very angry. Okay, and she said in indignant. Indignant means filled with anger. So Mother India is very angry, and these words are beating to my ears like a gong. Gong means a metal disc with a turned ring, that means jagate or something, say, you know, that one. So she says that the words of the poet are beating, that means are beating to Mother Earth ears like a gong. Okay, and she says, let it flew, okay, that about me a pitiful thing. So pitiful thing refers to the poet himself. Okay, so who says this? Mother India. So Mother India, she's stressing, that means she's saying the poet as a pitiful thing. Okay, so the words of the poet are beating to her ears like a gong. Okay, so she says that let it fly. Okay, and how it should fly? It should fly like a great white birds. I think you all understood. So said the mother in indignant word, that means in anger. Okay, Mother Earth in anger, she said the words. Okay, the words of the poet are beating, that means is hurt by Mother Earth like a gong. Okay, and she says let it fly, okay, about me a pitiful thing. Pitiful thing means refers to the poet. So Mother Earth is stressing a poet as a pitiful things, and the words of the poet are beating her ears like a gong. Okay, so she says let it fly, and how it should fly? It should fly like a great white bird. Okay, next line. Sing of the millions that toiled, sing of the wrinkled face indexing ignorance. Okay, so Mother India here, he asks, okay, if you want to sing a song, sing of the millions. So Mother India is asking the poet, sing of the millions that toiled. Toiled means that to work hard. Okay, to work hard to make our country developed. Okay, and also sing of those wrinkled faces. Okay, that means the one who work hard, and one who finds very difficulty to lead a life. Okay, so for example, they find it very difficult to assist the basic necessities. Okay, wrinkled face here refers to those who are working hard, okay, who are in completely sorrow. So she's asking, sing about those person who are tall, that means who are toiling, who are working very hard, And also seeing about those wrinkled face, that means the people who are working hard and who are completely in the sorrow. Indexing ignorance. Indexing means indicating. Okay, indexing ignorance, indicating ignorance. Ignorance means a lack of knowledge. Okay, so here Mother India is asking the poet, sing of a wrinkled face. Indexing ignorance, that means indicating ignorance. So here we can see that she is talking of the people who are ignorant, wrinkled, okay, the people who have lacked education. That means she is talking about the poverty and illiteracy. So she is telling that India is still with the poverty and ignorance and illiteracy. So she is asking the poet to sing of those things. Okay, she is trying to stress that India is still existing with the social evils. Okay, and afterwards she asks, sing of a helpless child, okay, that is born in the black dark home. So she is asking poet to sing of the helpless child. So here the helpless child, you can think about the child who doesn't have the parent. Okay, so she is asking the poet to sing of those helpless child, that means the child who doesn't have the parent. Okay, where they do not have the basic necessity, employment. So here the child, the mother is speaking about the helpless child born in the dark home. Okay, so the entire paragraph tells us that poet wants to talk about the glorious past of our country and about the things which make us to feel very proud. Okay, so now next paragraph. Nervous I yet would ask, deeming it my task, what song shall I sing of you, my mother, what song shall I sing? Okay, so here the poet is, here again the conversation is going on between the mother earth and the poet. And again the poet is feeling nervous in the third stanza. Okay, why? Because the mother earth, as you all know, in the second stanza, angrily she said in the indignant word, that makes the poet very nervous. Okay, deeming it my task, deeming means considering it my task. So the poet thinks that it's my task to sing a song of this country, to appreciate the beauty of the country. So deeming it my task, so the poet considered it is his task to sing about the beauty of our country. So so he says it's his task to sing, and I asked Mother India again, okay, what song shall I sing of the dam and the lake, of the steam mills, the shipyard building. Okay, so his poet thinks that it is his task to ask Mother Earth what song shall he sing. Okay, so he asks again Mother Earth, what song should he sing, whether he should sing about the lake, steel mills, ship building yard. So all this word, it tells us about the industrial growth. Okay, dams, lakes, steel mills, it speaks about the industrial progress, that means the growth and development of our country in the field of science and technology. So the poet here is asking about what shall I sing? Shall I sing about the dam and the lake, or steel mill? Steel mills, you know, that is iron processing factory. Okay, or ship building yard, that means a place where the ships are built. Okay, so he is asking what song shall I sing, whether can I sing about the steel mills, ship building yard, that means ship building yard, where the places where ships are built. Okay, so the poet asks, what song shall I sing of the dam or a lake or a steel mill or the shipbuilding yard of our country? Okay. Okay, next line. Of the men that worked hard to technologize, to put you on the page of the atomic age. So here the word to put you on the page means to put you in the page means to get recognized. So the previous line you heard, you learned that the poet wants to ask Mother Earth, what song shall I sing? He wants to ask whether he can sing about the dams, lakes, steel mills, and the shipbuilding yard. So Mother Earth says, now sing about the people who put you on the page. That means who worked hard to technologize, okay, to equip you with the well advanced science and technology. So the poet is asking the Mother Earth here that, so shall he sing of those men who worked hard to technologize her? Okay, next line. Okay, set the mother of these you may sing, but sing also the strikes early and late of iron men that comes in their way, of class war and the correlate. Okay, so previous line you understood that she wanted, that means the poet is very proud, okay, about all the things about the development of our country. So he wants to sing about that, but Mother Earth here, she says that sing about strikes, okay, early and late. Early means before independence, late means after independence. So she is asking the poet to sing about the strikes that was happened in the previous, that means before independence and after independence, and also about the iron men. Iron men means people who come in the way to solve this problem. Okay, that means to come behind them. Okay, so it means to solve their problem. Okay, so class war. The poet is talking about a class war. That means the war that goes on between the rich and the poor, and the upper caste and the lower caste. So the Mother Earth is asking the poet to sing about those class war and its correlate and its relationship. Okay. Next paragraph. Querulous, I said, is there any song that I can sing of you, heart whole unalloyed? Querulous means complaining. I said, I refers to a poet. So complaining here, the poet is asking Mother Earth, is there no song that he can sing heart whole? Heart whole means wholeheartedly, okay, and unalloyed. Unalloyed means very pure and cleared. Okay, so he is asking Mother Earth, is there no song that he can sing wholeheartedly, a pure song? Okay, so he is complaining here. Okay, so a song bathed in the stainless steel, unvaporizing in the void. Okay, so here the poet is asking for a song, okay, bathed in the stainless blue. Stainless blue means a very clear sea. Okay, so the poet is asking for the song that should be very clear like a sea. Okay, so next line, unvaporizing in the void. Unvaporizing in the void. Vapor means, you know, it disappear. Unvaporing means we should not disappear into the void. Void means nothingness. Okay, so here the poet is wishing to sing a song wholeheartedly. Now he want a clear and the pure song. That song, it should be like a clear sea, and that should not disappoint him in the nothingness. So here he is complaining to Mother India about his wish. I think you all understood. I'll repeat once again. A song bathed in the stainless steel, unvaporizing in the void. So here the line is like this. That song should be bathed in the stainless blue. Stainless blue means here clear sea. So that song should be bathed in the sea, unvaporizing in the void. As I told, vapor means disappear. Unvapor means we should not appear. Okay. So here the poet is wishing to a song wholeheartedly, and now he wanted the clear and the pure song. That song, it should be bathed in the clear sea, and that should not disappoint him in the nothingness. So here he is complaining to Mother Earth. That means he is asking Mother Earth about his wish. At that, the mother rose, draped in the sky, milk white ocean heaved around her. Okay. At that, the mother rose, draped in the sky, milk white ocean heaved around her. So here you have to imagine. Okay. So the poet here, he asks for the song. Okay. He asks for the song to the Mother Earth. So Mother Earth now rises in the sky. That means she rose. That means she rises in the sky. Okay. Draped in the blue sky. That means draped means, you know, that around something. Okay. So she rises in the sky, draped in the blues. Okay. Draped in the sky. That means draped in the blue sky. Okay. So next, milk white ocean heaved around her. So Mother India, she rises in the blue sky. Around her you have the milk white ocean. Okay. So heaved means to move powerfully. Okay. So what is around her? You have white milk white ocean. It is moving around her. Okay. So here, next line, entrancing. I think you all understood. So here the Mother Earth rises, draped in the blue sky, and you have around her the milk white ocean. Okay. Next line, where the entrancing and enthroning light. So through these oceans woven where. Okay. Entrancing and enthroning light. Entrancing means filled with wonder. Entrancing, filled with wonder. Okay. So waves were filled with wonder. Okay. And delight. So these waves were the throne of Mother India, where the entrancing and enthroning light. And so through these ocean waves were. Okay. So here entrancing and enthroning light, it means that filled with wonder. So here the waves were the throne of Mother India. Okay. So next line. On which she sat and wrote the book of morrow. Okay. Where did she sit? She sat on the throne. So what is her throne? Waves. Waves are considered as a throne of Mother India. And what is she doing? She is writing a book. That is a book of morrow. Morrow means tomorrow. Okay. So the poet here, he says that Mother India, she rises up in the blue sky. At the same time, she has been surrounded by the milk white ocean. And she has been seated on the waves. And waves are filled with the wonder and the delight. Okay. And what is she doing sitting on the waves? She is writing the book of morrow. Okay. That is book of tomorrow. Okay. That is a book of tomorrow means a book of future India. So I think you all understood. Last stanza, it say the poet says that Mother India, she rises in the blue sky, draped in the blue sky, and she sits on the waves. That means waves act like a seat of the Mother Earth, and she writes there the book of morrow, the book of tomorrow, filled with wonder and delight. Okay, hoping that the tomorrow, that means tomorrow, bright future of India. So she sits on the sea and she writes the book on the future of India. So this is the summary of the poem.